So here we are with Google Tasks, and we're going to show you how to utilize Google Tasks and make the most of it if you're looking to use Google's task management experience. In today's video, we're going to go over everything you need to know about this and everything in between. Hello, my name is Francesco. Welcome to Keep Productive. If you want to subscribe, you can. It'd be awesome to have you. And also, if you'd like to jump into find other to-do list applications or general productivity tools, you can find it up here or just down below here. You can find any productivity tool on Tool Finder, and we'll help you find the best one. So as you can see here, I'm actually on Google Calendar, but if you go to Google Calendar and you can see up here, you can switch over to something called Tasks. Now Tasks is available as an iOS, Android app, and also a web version in a slightly different way because it's available through this web portal type experience. And also you may notice it on the right hand side when you're using Google Workspace or Google Gmail applications and things like that. Now, if we go back to this view, what you can do here is you can go ahead and do two things inside of the likes of Google Tasks. And if I press create, I can add a new task. Now you can add it to any of the lists you created, and you can also create a new list, which will allow you to organize any tasks into there. And in this case, I might add an email to action. In this case, I'll just call it Google Tasks. You can add a description, have it to repeat, and even have an all day event or an all day task. Now you can see it landed inside of here. Now they have this nice Kanban view, allowing me to move stuff around the different lists that I do have inside of Google Tasks. And you can see here that I can even set recurring ones. So clear email every day, and I can take them off nicely. Now you may notice here, okay, what are these? Well, very simply, these are allowing you to capture emails. We'll come to that in a moment, but very simply, there are some really neat little abilities with Google Calendar, Google Documents, and Google Gmail that you can use Google Tasks with. Now, if you don't want to see a specific list, you can show and hide them, and you can even just have one list if you do want to. But if you want to create a new list, you can do it by adding it down here. And if I title it new list, you can see that that pops up in the right hand corner. Now you can actually sort this by date, even starred, and even rename it as well. But what's cool as well is if anything that is starred will appear in this starred area, and you can even add a starred item from here. Now this also connects to Google Spaces. So if you star a task inside of Google Spaces or bring it in from a specific Google Space or chat that you're working in, it will save that task for later. And it works very similar to what we're going to show you with Gmail and Google Documents. So as you can see, there's not much else you can do. You can actually assign it to a type of person. I'll come back to that in a moment. And you can also click in and add a little bit of detail as well. You can add a date ahead of time. In this case, if I change a date, obviously it modifies that, and I can move stuff around. Down here, completed items are shown here. So it gives you a bit of an indicator of what's completed, and you can move the list to the first position if you did want to as well. So very basic stuff in terms of the task management side of stuff. I can go over to here and see some of the task command shortcuts. This is probably better to learn separately, but if you're learning and wanting to hack it out together a little bit, you can indent stuff, you can change all of the list actions and learn all these functionalities, which is very helpful. Now on this right hand side, you can actually pop open your Google Keep, which might be helpful if you're correlating tasks to some of the things that you're working on. But let's dive over to Google Documents to show you the first ability. And there is an ability inside of here is if you press at and you mention event calendar draft and I press enter, you can get this calendar draft pop up, which is very nice. That's great for Google Calendar because you can start inviting certain people. But just below it, you could, if you wanted to, just very simply press at and then task. And as you can see, a task will appear. So if I wanted to say event conference and assign it to myself and give it a date, actually I'm going to assign it to that account and then press assign, what happens, you see in the right hand corner, is a task will pop up, but it also correlates it to the document that you're working on as well. And this is in particular very helpful because it will save you a bunch of time coming back to that. If you click it, it'll take you direct to the task that you were working on. So again, very helpful when coordinating your workload. Now one of the nice things as well is you can do this inside of the likes of Google Calendar. If I were to set something, for example, I have a task in here called clear email, just because it's constantly reminding me. If I have clear email in there and it's set as daily, it's going to come up as an all day task. But if I have something that's specific, like 11:30 a.m. Google task that I created a moment ago, it's going to come as a time block inside of my calendar. So if I can mark as complete, which is very helpful, but you can also go ahead and drag a bunch of time out for tomorrow and change it into a task. In this case, it could be a schedule YouTube and I press save, but I can create a nice little sort of block of time, which is quite nice. I can go in, I can change the information behind it and press save. It doesn't give you a time block per se, like an extensive block of time, but very helpful for just moving stuff around that you might want to work on. So in terms of the Gmail abilities, this is quite helpful. If I go back over and I go over to, I think I had emails to action, this one, which I saved a very long time ago, and I press this, it's going to take me directly into the email that it's correlating. And obviously this is such an outdated email, but let me show you how this works. If I go to inbox and I go to start, so when you're inside of the likes of Gmail, this only works, I believe, inside of regular Gmail accounts, not Google Workspace. I can drag anything into here and it saves it as a task and correlates to the exact email that you've got working. So I can go ahead and add that for tomorrow and that task will appear inside of my Google Tasks account. You can also right click and go down to add to tasks and it will do the same for you. So if you're using Google Tasks and Google's experiences across your day, this is probably going to be beneficial to you. But largely, it's a very lightweight experience that's going to be very basic for many people. But as you can imagine, a great starting point for your task management when you're getting started with Google products. So thank you very much. I hope you found this video helpful. Remember, do subscribe if you fancy diving into more productivity tools. But if you're in the hunt for more productivity tools, you can jump over to Tool Finder, which will link below and in the top corner as I speak right now. So thank you very much. And I'll see you all very soon, I'm sure. Cheerio. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, you can check out another video here on YouTube diving into productivity tools. But if you did want to, you can jump over to Tool Finder to discover any productivity tools, which will be linked here as well. We have a resource of over 250 productivity tools and growing. And naturally, there are reviews, insights, and much more. So do check it out below. But thank you very much for watching this video.